Ben from SL6 here, folks, with the Solidline SL6 flashlight. This little guy was developed by a Ledlenser, made with a lot of their technologies, slightly down-spec to make it really affordable so you can get all the Ledlenser features without the high price tag. Now, don't be fooled into thinking this might be a cheaper version of Ledlenser's torches. It's made by Ledlenser to the same quality with a lot of the same features. They've just used a few different materials and removed some of the features to make it affordable for those who want a good quality torch but don't want to spend on the high-end version but want something a little bit better than an entry-level torch that you get off the shelf. Now, the torch weighs about 93 grams or thereabouts without the batteries, 130 grams with the batteries inside. That depends on what batteries you use, obviously. It takes three AAA batteries, either alkaline or nickel metal hydride. Now, it measures in its compact version like this, 13.1 centimeters. This then extends out, the zoom function here extends out to 13.5 centimeters, 3.2 centimeter diameter at the head and 2.9 centimeter, or about 3 centimeter diameter throughout the torch. It's made with an ABS plastic. So when you talk ABS plastic, think Lego. Lego's made out of that plastic, which just lasts forever, and it has got a really solid feel about it. The one thing I like about the SL6 version in this range is that it has got this metal pocket clip here, which is a nice low profile pocket clip. It can be removed if you like. I'll show you shortly how you can remove that. It's ABS plastic throughout. There's a polycarbonate lens in the end here, and it's got many of Ledlenser's sort of focusing features in here. We'll show you what that looks like shortly. Same sort of quality, but not quite the same light, but still really good. On the end here, you've got a rubber switch that I'll show you shortly how all those features work, but that scrolls through all the features of the torch, and then this end cap unscrews. There's a rubber seal around this, so IP54 rating for it all, which makes it dust and water resistant. So water resistant to sort of splashing. And then it does have, as I mentioned, this metal pocket clip here. Won't quite come off at the moment, but you've just got to get it past the rubber seal there, so you can remove that if you want, but you probably really don't need to because it sits nice and profile against the body here anyway. I'll show you the cartridge inside actually. So there's the three batteries in there. You get three AAA batteries included with the torch. That just slots in there, and then this does up. Now when you do this up, you just need to make sure the hole on the pocket clip lines up with the little notch in the body of the torch there. Otherwise it won't turn on. So line that up, screw this back on. Let's come clear again, and we're good to go. Now, I'll show you the zoom function. So if I turn this on, I'll shine it straight back down at the ground here. That's the highest setting. If I zoom in, we can see that there's a reasonably focused beam there. Now, the difference between this and the high-end Ledlenser torches is that in this midsection here, you do sort of get a little bit of darkness in the middle here. On the flood setting, it's a nice even light. On the zoom setting, it's a nice focus light, but in between, you just get a few sort of dark patches. So that's just one spot where I guess the design of this has been cut back a little to make it a really affordable torch, but still maintaining that quality. Now I'm gonna leave it on the zoom setting here because I wanna show you how to use the torch through the button on the end here. Actually, I just reminded myself there's one other thing up here, which is a little hole, so you can put a lanyard through there. You don't get the lanyard included, but you could put a string through there to keep it secure on your wrist if you like. Now, the settings are all through this button on the end here. So if I just shine it down against the side of the cupboard here, I'll turn it off to start with. So the first setting, let me just scroll through the settings. So I'm going back to the boost setting. So I turn that on, that is now the boost setting there. So that's 320 lumens with 140 meter beam distance. If I turn that off and then on again in quick succession, it goes to the power setting, which is one step down, 120 lumens, 85 meter beam distance and about 9 hours of runtime. If I turn it off and on again quickly, you can just see the low power setting there, just a little bit of light. 30 lumens, 20 meter beam distance, and up to 25 hours of runtime. I turn it off and back on again, it goes back to the power setting. So, which I should mention, it doesn't have a memory. So if you turn this off, if I had that on the low setting, leave it off, turn it back on again, it goes back to the boost setting. To get it back to the low setting, you gotta scroll through all three again. There is one other little feature I've noticed that you can do a half press. You don't turn it all the way on, but if I just press this lightly, you can do a momentary light. So I'm only just holding down on that button there. And that scrolls through the same three settings if you just do a half press in succession. So I can quickly get to the low setting if I like by just doing three quick presses, and there's the low setting there, but I haven't clicked the button all the way in, but I can then click it all the way in to maintain that low setting. So if I want to go, rather than just go straight to bright, I want to go to low, three small presses, one, two, three. Oh, sorry, one, two, Let me do that again. Two presses to get to the low setting. One, two, and then click it on, and we're on the low setting. So simplified version of the button there can be good in some instances, because many torches have a lot of functions going through the one button, but quite functional and a really good light. This is a really good option, nice and slim line, slips in a pocket on the side of your belt, whatever. Really good option for campers or outdoorsmen to keep in a backpack, in a glove box or whatever, because it gives a really good light in a really durable casing, lightweight, and it's really affordable. You can check them out online at snowys.com.au where you find them at the lowest prices every day. But if you've got any questions, let us know down in the comments below. Subscribe to our channel for all of our latest info, or check out some other Ledlenser torches, like these ones down here.